Big story at 5. A Memphis cotton company says a supervisor who was recorded making racist comments in the workplace is now fired. A story first reported by WREG. Thanks for joining us. I'm Richard Ransom.
I'm Claudia Barr. Now, workers inside the Atkinson Cotton Warehouse recorded the comments and gave them to us. Listen as one man told an African-American worker he couldn't use the water fountain.
Hey, I need to put a sign here that says white people only.
The warehouse owner now wants to tell his side of the story.
He told WREG Sabrina Hall he wasn't around enough to know about the alleged abuse.
I just wasn't around. I wish if I, you know, I'm sorry that I didn't know that sooner.
E.W. Atkinson says he's as shocked as anyone else by the recordings.
I'm gonna use the microwave.
No, hell no.
Why I can't use your microwave, man?
No, you're not white.
And these men's stories.
Telling me the black man don't get on this white man's lip.
He'll be like, you need to think like a white man.
Atkinson says he had no idea the supervisor running his cotton warehouse could be saying racist remarks to black workers.
I don't want people to think that we would let this behavior go on without doing something about it, seriously.
He said, shut up, don't you hear white people in here talking?
Antonio Harris says he was so sick of the treatment at work, he recorded his boss on his cell phone. Now what he caught on audio is being heard nationwide.
What they do when they catch me drinking your water?
I couldn't believe he'd say that.
Atkinson responded today to the EEOC complaint filed against his business, saying while Harris and Mario Mangrum were his employees, he takes no responsibility for what the supervisor said. He says he outsources that management to another company, Federal Compress, and the supervisor is that company's employee. Federal Compress released this statement saying it conducted a thorough and extensive investigation. The person was immediately removed from the workplace and is in fact no longer employed by Federal Compress.
So who should be held responsible?
Well, I think they're going to talk to both of us.
The EEOC is working on a settlement now with Atkinson Cotton Warehouse.
Hey, black boy, get over there and get my cotton.
For these two men.
Every day, this the same thing where we are here every day.
Who still live with painful memories from just trying to earn a paycheck.
And that was Sabrina Hall reporting. Atkinson says his family has been in the cotton business for more than 60 years, and they've never had a discrimination charge filed against them.